Thank you. So I was asked to read this thing by this poem slash story, and as I read it, I couldn't help but think about winter. And no, not just because the title is winter, but because of the language that Cougar Wisdom used within this piece. It's perfect. It's awe-inspiringly brilliant. I think you'll agree with me when you hear his words flow through me in this story. First off, I want to know how many people have ever thought about winter. I know there's more of them because I saw the awkward audience shift in their seat thing. You know what I'm talking about? Oh my gosh, you asked a question. What do I do? Oh God, I'll smile. Yeah, honestly, if you ever thought about it as you were a kid, or if you thought about it last year or 10 minutes ago, or if you're thinking about it now because you're already sick of hearing me speak, let me see how many people thought about winter. Come on. Come on. Right, yeah, exactly. Exactly. I know you, yeah. Exactly, winter. You think of it like the snow, how it blankets the earth, and there's this quiet about, right? And how the sun makes the snow sparkle with such beauty. It's like 1,000 diamonds that sparkle when the snow glistens in the sun. Did you ever think of that? It's beautiful. You found it. Yeah. Yeah. And it's so appropriate that the earth should have winter. Just to rest. With all the preparations around the corner, with spring just right around the corner, with all the activities that summer brought with it. Even when you're skiing. When you're skiing, you can even smell the freshness of the snow. You can hear nothing but silence as the snow falls. Just has me lost in thought. It's beautiful. And you can see the fresh tracks of the wood creatures as they're skiing along, as they were searching for their food. And you know their eyes are on you as you're skiing through the wood, but they aren't going to move. No, so they're not going to disturb the day. They're not going to disturb the day. They don't want to even be seen. We are as one in the silent of the wood on a snowy day. I mean, wouldn't that be a perfect place to stop and just rest? Wouldn't it? I mean, the trees, just picture this, the trees laden with snow. It makes me think of snow angels, snow ghosts, and some branches are even, still have the ice that are frozen on them. And as the sun shines, the snow melts, and some branches look as though they're weeping with the melting of the ice. But there are no tears of sadness here, no. No tears of sadness are shed. Only the acknowledgement of change. And that is the beauty of the silent of the wood. I mean, to acknowledge this peace in this quiet. I mean, it displays itself so well. I mean, don't you think? Oh boy, you ask another question. I mean, to acknowledge this peace and this quiet is to know that we are a part of this, that we are a part of that. I mean, that's the way of it. We are an integral part of the snow, the sun, the peace, the quiet, the earth. And it too is a part of me, a part of us. And that is the way of the circle. Think about it. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
I'm going to tell you one of my favorite Christmas stories. The Christmas Story. This is from a book called The Jesus Loves Me Bible, storybook version. And the title of the story is God Became a Baby Boy. I'll make sure you guys can see the pictures too. One night, an angel came to Joseph in a dream. "Don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife," the baby inside her is from the Holy Spirit, the angel said. "You will call him Jesus, which means the Lord saves." So Joseph and Mary were married. The emperor said that all the people must go to their birthplaces to list their names and to pay taxes. Joseph and Mary traveled many miles to Bethlehem, their hometown. Mary was very tired, but there was no place to rest. Bethlehem was crowded with people, and Mary and Joseph had to spend a night in the stable. During the night, Mary's baby was born. Mary loved her wonderful son. She wrapped him in warm clothes and made a cozy bed for him in a feed box. Some shepherds were watching their sheep in a nearby field. Suddenly an angel appeared. The shepherds were frightened. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I'm bringing you good news. Tonight your Savior was born in Bethlehem. He is Christ the Lord." The end.
just wanted to frame this next song with that story, just so you have that kind of on your palette. And this is a John Denver song that I really like. It's off of the Muppets Christmas album, which is a great album. You should check it out.
Thank you. You are the new day.
Yes.
just allow people up here to briefly introduce themselves and let us know just your name and what you're doing for a career or what.
For a career. What's your career?
We'll go like super, super quick. My name is Dan Roeder. I work here and I also work at Simonson Lumber.
My name is Allison Fay, and I'm the Minister to Youth and Children at the Episcopal Church in White Bear Lake, and I'm the Case Manager for the Jacob Wetterling Foundation.
My name is Laura Ewing, and I'm in graduate school at the University of Wisconsin-Madison in music.
My name is Aliza Ewing, and I am the Education and Outreach Coordinator at a museum at the University of Iowa in Iowa City.
I'm Amanda Weiss, and I go to St. Ben's for music.
I'm Maggie Latterell, and I go to NDSU for theater.
I'm Sarah Grimsby McQuaid, and I went to Gustavus, and that's how I met Dan and Diana, and I currently coordinate ad sales for a company that makes website for TV news stations.
I'm Diana Hamilton, and I'm a family lawyer.
I'm Eileen Lawler, and I'm a Master's of Education student, geography for middle school.
I'm Erin Durga, and I teach first grade in Rifle, Colorado.
I'm Andrew Hasty, and I teach high school choir here at Stock Rapids High School.
I'm Mitchell Lee Skyeski, and my profession is acting.
I think it's so interesting just to see the breadth of what we're involved with outside of this, and I feel so blessed that we can gather here tonight to enjoy the gift of music. With that, let's eat.